BRCA1 plus muscular dystrophy equals for surgeries in 3 years. Yup, it's a lot. Giving me 100 years old vibes.
So, a filter free real talk. We've had a few rants with Rake, a few crazy moments, a few morphine moments. Today is a little anniversary, depending on which month we're in, but anyway, I don't even know that poem, how many, January, June, 31. It's been 30 days today since double mastectomy, preventative, prophylactic, meaning didn't have cancer, had heaps of lumps, had a 96-98% chance of getting breast cancer or ovarian cancer or both. And because I live with muscular dystrophy and use a wheelchair now, at 46 years old, I've had a pretty good shot, and this little body's given me miracle babies and heaps of blessings, and I've tortured it sometimes. I've been really good to it for a while now. I stopped work a few months ago to train for the surgery. I've already had two. 2020, when I found out about the cancer risk, I had a hysterectomy, so all women, factory things out, threw me into instant menopause, rocky road. Lots of medication, lots of weight gain, lots of emotional stuff. And then this was the last part of it. Took ages because of COVID. Surgery was cancelled and rebooked 5 times. Long, boring story short, hysterectomy was major emotionally and physically. Then hernia, day 3, when I had to get out of bed and my body wasn't ready. That was major surgery. Then the breasts off, had 3 proper cancer scares in 3 years, sort of 4. And so was like, yeah, I can't take this anxiety anymore. Checking every day, every lump thing, it was the last. Every 3 months, days off, scares, anxiety. So kept booking, kept training. Took a huge toll on career, business, family, mental health, friendships. I didn't see coming, like, it's been huge. And then finally had the surgery 30 days ago yesterday, so both breasts were removed, and very small, very humble little bits, made out of some of my safe own tissue left. Didn't want silicone after all the silicone sickness. Didn't want surgical mesh because of all those complications. Also, because of my muscular dystrophy, can't guarantee 5 years, 7 years, I can go in and have revision surgeries, and my seat belts, my standing frames, my physio, all push on my chest. So lots of things to consider. Also, any woman find it hard to fight breast cancer, and some men, apologies, but with actively fighting muscular dystrophy anyway, just seemed like a shitty plan. What a journey. Like, because I've got muscular dystrophy, I've watched many people survive it, battle it, and many friends pass from it. So I've always sort of felt like I'm living on eggshells and an egg timer to do as much as I can, as fast as I can. It's given me a different worldview. Excuse me. And then this time we're in a carer shortage, like just everything, you know. So luckily I work in the disability sector, have for many years, so I was able to acquire some funding support, some equipment, some support staff, and luckily